Hi, this is Tony from Switzerland with another knife review. Today we're going to take a look at a French company that builds more traditional style knives, and the company is called Claude Dozorn, which is the name of one of the sons of the founder. And you also can see that the logo of the company is a wolf's head, and that is because the founder of the company, Blaise Dozorn, had the nickname Wolf because of his very enigmatic personality, so they kept that and took it as their logo. But first of all, we're gonna take a look at the history and the beginnings of the company, and at the meantime, take a look at the catalog and see what kind of knives they produce in France. So here is the catalog, and you also can see that they are very proud that they built their knives in France. At the front of the catalog, you have a lot of info about the history. So Claude Dozorn Cutlery is a family-run business in the fourth generation right now. Claudine Dozorn is the head of the company nowadays, and she's the daughter of Claude Dozorn. So here we have the first model that they produce here in the catalog, and it is the liner lock folder. That they have a very lightweight and minimalist construction and interpretation of the Lagiol style knives. And you can see they always produce their knives in a lot of different handle materials, which I really like. So you really have a selection where you can choose the one that you like the best. Here they also have some black coated blades of the liner lock Lagiol interpretation. And here you have some other varieties of that same knife, but here you have it in the tiered blade shape. So the tiered blade shape is another traditional style of knife in the French culture from the capital of the French cutlery industry, Le Thiers, and it is quite different from the traditional Laguiole, which is also another cutlery city in France. And here you can see some other liner lock locking knives. So all these you have seen until now are locking blades, but they also produce different varieties of non-locking blades, which is typical for all these French manufacturing companies. And now let's take a look at some more higher-end models that they offer. You can see here also in the Le Thiers blade shape, you have the Secret here on the left side, which has a very, very intricate milling on the or a file work on the spring, and also a lot of different handle materials, as they always do with their knives. And on the right side, you have the RLT model, which is the one we are going to talk about in this video. And we have a model of this knife in the black horn scale, as you can see here. So, really, really interesting knife. And now let's take a look at the real deal. So this is the packaging that your Thiers RLT from Claude Dozorn Cutlery comes to you. A very handsome packaging with this nice Claude Dozorn ribbon that they have here. And if you open it up like this, you are presented with your certificate of your guarantee. It is in French and also in English. And you also have a little card that explains to you the build of the knife and all the different features that they put into this knife. And on the other side, you also have some additional information and a takedown picture of the RLT right here. So really interesting and really cool thing that I did here with this little information card in there. And then the knife is presented to you like that, and you also get a takedown tool for the proprietary pivot in the package as well, which I always like. If manufacturers use some proprietary pivot screws, they always should provide you with the tool to adjust or take down the knife. So now let's take the knife out of the box and let's take a closer look at it. Here you have the knife in the closed position with the gorgeous black horn handles. which are polished but have not lost their natural structuring, which looks really, really nice here on this knife. Gives it a very, very nice touch. You also have some stainless steel bolsters and a mirror polished blade. So a really handsome traditional style knife in the tier blade shape pattern, and you also have some file work on in the back. So that as a first little overview of the knife. But now let's take a look at the specs of the knife. As always, in the open position, the Claude Desarmes RLT has an overall length of 8.4 inches or 21.3 centimeters, which gives you a blade length of 3.5 inches or 9 centimeters, and a handle length of 5 inches or 12.6 centimeters. The blade is made out of 14C28N steel, which is a really nice high quality Sandvik steel, which we're going to talk about later on in the video a little bit more. And you also have a blade thickness of 3 millimeters, which comes to a very fine and acute point, so you can do a lot of nice detail work with this RLT model from Claude Desarmes. Now let's take a look at the weight of this traditional knife. And the RLT by Claude Desarmes weighs 142 grams, or about 5 ounces, which in the realm of the traditional knives is a pretty good weight. And considering all the steel that is used in this construction, like the back spring, the bolsters, and also the liners, I think this is a pretty nice weight for the overall style and manufacturing of the knife right here. Now let's take a closer look at the 3.5 inch long 14C28N Sandvik steel blade of the RLT by Claude Desarmes. And you can see here it wears a really nicely executed mirror polish. You can really see all the reflections in there and not a single scratch. So very, very well done there. You also have some markings on the blade, the litière, which is the name of a product line of Claude Desarmes, and that it is made by Claude Desarmes and 100% built in France is marked right here. And you also have the tiers logo from the French capital of the knife industry right here, and that is also wearing the traditional tiers blade shape as well. So this T inside of the box is the designation for that. On the other side of the blade, you have no markings whatsoever, very sterile. So the tiers blade shape is a standard or slight drop point blade shape, which is a really nice utility style blade shape. You also have a nail nick that is actually a hole in the blade, so it's a little bit easier to extract the knife out of the handle. I think that is a really nice addition and then a slight modernization of the traditional tiers blade shape. And the 14C28N Sandvik is a steel that I have raved about prior to this video in a lot of different knife reviews that I have done. For example, the Echelon review that I have done, which is also wearing the 14C28N steel, which is a steel that I really, really love. It has a fine grain structure, very good rust resistance, and a good edge retention. So really nice overall steel choice. There are also a lot of other high-end folders like the Southern Grind, Bad Monkey, that are using this kind of steel. So steel choice on this knife is a really, really well done by Claude Desarmes. And also the blade shape is quite utilitaristic and also good looking and a very elegant overall design in my opinion. Now let's take a closer look at the beautiful handle construction here of the Claude Desarmes RLT. You can see here mine is wearing the black bone scales. There are also a lot of different scales. There is a carbon fiber version, also a lot of different wood versions available of this blade, and a light horn as well, so you really can choose the one you like the best. And you can see here the horn is polished and feels very nice in hand, but it has not lost its natural structure, as you can see here coming through on some places on the horn right here, and also on the other side. So I really like that they haven't just totally polished it, so it really has kept its natural look a little bit here on this handle construction. Something that is unique on the handle construction for a traditional knife is that the knife is completely disassemblable. You have here Torx screws on both sides, three of them, to attach your scales, which you can take apart. And here you have the proprietary pivot screw, which you get the tool in the box that you have seen before, so you can disassemble that as well. You also can see here the nice fit and finish and tolerances on the transition from the scale to the bolster, also very, very well done. And as I said, you can take the knife completely apart to clean it, or if you have to fix something. And another really, really nice addition to this knife is that it actually runs on ball bearings, which is unheard of for a traditional knife, as far as I know. So it's a really, really smooth operating knife, but still has the really nice traditional lines and features of a folder of this design. So you can see here you have really well done file work on the spine here of the spring. Really, really well done. And you also can see here the tolerances and fit and finish on the liners to the spring and then to the scales. Everything is just flawlessly executed. Very, very well done. So overall, the handle design is just extremely gorgeous. The fit and finish is also very, very well done. All the stainless steel parts on the handle are polished to a mirror polish, as well as the blade, so it ties the look together extremely well, and it just looks very good. But also, it seems to be a very minimalistic handle and flows very nicely with the overall design of the blade. But it's actually a really ergonomic handle. It has a really good size with its 5 inches, and it also fits the hand quite well. But of course, it is a slip joint, but the spring is really quite strong, so you're not going to fold it in very easily. So overall, the handle construction and design is excellently executed on this knife, and I really like all the different handle materials that you can choose on their website. And I really like how they tie the look together with the polished accents all around here on the knife. And also the thickness is very nice and hand filling, so you really can do a lot of work without getting any kind of hot spots on the handle of this blade. But of course, because it's a traditional folder, you don't have any kind of pocket clip or anything like that on this blade, so that's just something to keep in mind. Now let's take a look at the action of the RLT by Claude Dazon. And the name RLT comes actually from the ball bearing used in this knife. So the full designation of the ball bearing system used in the RLT is actually RLT 693, and is a caged stainless steel ball bearing system that really works flawlessly here in this model by Claude Dazon. It ensures a really, really nice and smooth opening and closing of this knife without any problem. And of course, because it is a slip joint knife, you don't have to disengage any kind of lock to close the knife again. And it's just really nice to see these traditional knife and knife companies to add some more advanced technologies like a ball bearing system to their traditional designs and make them just function a lot better than the traditional pivot styles that they have used before. So a really nice addition and modernization to a traditional design that Claude Dazon has developed here in the RLT. And also the execution of this new technology is really well done, because you can see you also have a extremely nice centering right out of the box. Quite perfect centering right here. Very smooth overall deployment with the RLT ball bearing system, and also no side to side play on this knife. And of course, the up and down play is not an issue in a slip joint folder, but there also is none until you break the spring tension to close the knife. So really nice overall. Now let's take a look at the sharpness of the Glottosrum RLT. I now had this knife for around a month and used it mostly for opening letters and a little bit of food prep, mostly around the house. And now you can take a look at the sharpness of the 14C28N after about a month of use. And you can see the 14C28N is just phenomenal steel, and they did a really nice job on sharpening and heat treating here in this French company. Just a breeze to cut with the RLT, really impressive, and just another statement for the excellent 14C28N blade steel, in my opinion. Very well done, Glottosrum, on your RLT model. Now let's come to the size comparisons I like to do. And the first size comparison I have for you is another very cool and unique slip joint folder out of Bulgaria. And it is the Manly Comrade. This one is the D2 model. There is also a CPM 154 model available of this knife. And you can see these two knives are quite similar in the overall size. And also both of them are slip joint knives. So legality wise, this should be quite similar. So in places like Germany and other places where you can't have a locking blade on your person, these two are certainly some really, really nice options. So these two are quite similar in the overall size, and also legality-wise, they shouldn't be an issue. So really cool slip joint knife with these grooved G10 handles. Of course, not as traditional as your RLT right here with the horn handles. Now, another comparison that I have for you is also a slip joint knife that I have reviewed not too long ago. It is the Miguel Nieto Climber version. It is, of course, a smaller knife, but also one of my very, very handsome and beloved slip joint knives. You can see overall it is quite a bit smaller, but also a really nice slip joint option. You have the AN58 steel here on the Climber. It's also a good steel, but I think the 14C28N is one or two steps above the AN58 steel, in my opinion. And as a last comparison, I have for you not a slip joint folder, but a folder that really reminded me here of the RLT. It is the Spyderco JD Smith, one of my more rare pieces in the collection, and also a really, really handsome blade. And you can see size-wise, these two are also a little bit similar. The JD Smith is a bit longer overall, but these two knives are also some really cool high-end folders, in my opinion, that have some similarity but also, of course, some differences. You have a lockback and a one-handed opening hole here on the JD Smith. So I hope this size comparison could give you an idea of the size of the Glottosrum RLT. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion on the Glottosrum RLT. So if you want to get yourself this knife, it's going to cost you around $160 depending on where you're getting it. And you're going to find a link to my recommended retailer in the description box below. But I think for that amount of money, if you like the overall design of these traditional slip joint folding knives, you're certainly going to like the RLT. And with the RLT, you're going to get things that you are not going to see on a lot of other traditional folding knives from other manufacturers, like the ball bearing system, which makes this knife an extremely smooth opening and closing knife. You also have a hole instead of a traditional nail nick, so it's easier to deploy. You have really, really gorgeous handle materials that you can choose from, and you can take the knife apart if you have to, because it's put together by Torx screws and a proprietary pivot screw that you get your disassembly tool with it in the box. So you really have a lot of things that you wouldn't expect from a traditional knife, but you also have the things that you would expect, like the really, really artistic file work here on the back of the blade, and the really nice fit and finish on the bolsters and everything like that, the extremely well executed mirror polish on the blade and all the stainless steel parts of the knife, and the traditional handle materials like horn and wood but also carbon fiber, which is really a thing this knife does the best. It really combines the traditional way of knife making with the modern way of knife making, and is in that respect a really important and really cool knife design in my opinion. And it's also the thing that attracted me to the RLT, because as you know, I don't have a wide variety of slip joint or traditional folding knives in my collection, but this knife was just a really nice blend of the two cultures of knife making, and that's why I was really attracted to this knife. And on top of that, it has one of my most favorite steels, the 14C28N, which just put it over the top for me. So overall, a really nice traditional knife with the right features of the modern knife making implemented, and still uses a lot of handwork that makes things like this really nice file work in the back possible. So I'm a really big fan of the RLT right here, and think for the price that they are asking for, they put out a really supreme product in my opinion. So that was my review of the Claude Dosorme RLT knife. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any question about the RLT, Claude Dosorme, the company, or anything else I talked about in the video, please leave it in the comments and I'll try to answer you there. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun, and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.